like the entertainment capital of the world, it's the new Tom Green Show. Tonight, from Jackass, Steve-O. Rap artist, Bubba Sparks. Back by popular demand, Dr. Franklin Roll. A clip from Funny French People. And Scott on piano. And me, I'm Glenn Hublick. And now, Tom Green!
You guys have to be the greatest audience we've ever had here. Now I'll pull my nose out of your collective asses and we'll start the show. This is our fourth week on the air. The honeymoon. Thank you, Charmin. Fourth week on the air, the honeymoon is over. Based on my track record with honeymoons, 4 weeks is pretty damn good. I had kind of an ironic moment over the weekend. I got a pirated copy of Pirates of the Caribbean. Hey, did you hear about this? Hey, you guys hear about this in the news Friday? Michael Jackson actually compared himself to Mahatma Gandhi. He really did this, actually. Yeah. I was surprised. I didn't know Gandhi had sex with little boys. Hey, Glenn and I had a charming little weekend. We actually went for a walk on the beach this weekend, Glenn and I. It was cute, actually. At one point, a hermit crab shed its little shell, and it crawled right up Glenn's ass. Tonight on the show, we have Steve-O from Jackass. Yeah. Crazy. Wow. Yeah, and Dr. Franklin Rule's coming back, too. You know that?
Later on today, yeah.
We tried to spend some time with Dr. Franklin Rule last week. We ran out of time. He's a UFO expert, and we're very excited about having him back. We like him very, very much around here. I don't know if you remember last week on the show, Roger Lodge from the popular syndicated television program Blind Date was on the show, and he made a promise to me, and let's have a look at what he said. Roger Lodge.
My goal in life now is to get Tom Green laid.
That'll be much harder than you would expect. Well, here's what happened. Roger actually kind of tried to follow through on that promise. He sent on the weekend. Glenn and I went out on a double date, courtesy of Roger Lodge. He sent a limousine over, and two lovely ladies. He sent in the limousine, mm-hmm. But it didn't really go perfectly. This is very, very serious. This is very real. We have some videotape to show you. It's not a skit. Okay, this is what happened. Start off. Limo came, picked us up with these girls. Glenn gets in a fight with his date, probably within the first 10 seconds. Let's have a look at that. Let's have a look at Glenn fighting with his date first.
How are you?
Where are you going?
Where are we going?
He's driving us, I think.
Stop it, giving him hate,
He's just trying to catch an attitude with me. No, but you're a little mean with him.
Don't catch an attitude. I said I would go dancing with a limo driver. What is your problem? Stop the attitude.
Did you think it was rude what she said outside, sir?
Thank you. You can put that up again.
See, that was rude.
No, we're on good terms.
Glenn, why are you always trying
you're so
to like?
Mental.
Why are you always?
Oh, you just hit me in the head.
At this point, I was starting to realize that we were not going in the right direction here. What were you doing? First of all, why did you start that argument?
Well, she was kind of rude to the driver, and I thought I called her on it.
You're Hollywood Humplick.
I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm nice to people. And
no,
was,
you're rude to the drivers.
Like,
you're rude
never,
to your
I'm
driver.
Never.
I hear you're. I
drive a Toyota. What are you talking about?
I hear you're rude to your driver.
Never had a driver in my life.
Yeah. Okay, so then you know, we thought maybe we could pull this one out of the rough here, but then the two girls, who I thought were quite charming, began to argue with each other. Have a look at that.
One thing is to have animal rights. When you go overboard, then it becomes ridiculous.
If you like animals, do you know what they go through before you can actually wear that fur? Do you know how to kill
yes,
them?
Yes, actually I do.
They put 240 volts. Of electricity anal.
Actually, I think that's all fabricated. Those are lies.
Why are you patronizing me, in my opinion?
No, I'm not. This issue is not revolving around you. It was not revolving around you. It was not revolving around you.
It was a
No, it wasn't revolving around you.
I'm sorry, why do you keep going on like this?
Oh, you must having a brain, lapse here. You're forgetting what you're saying. I don't have to look at you! It doesn't have to look at you. It's too bad. It's a face that you're being pathetically stupid right now.
Well, let's go dancing.
You can tell that I was a little worried. I was hoping that things would go well, and I was seeing things going in the... You see my arm around my date? My arm?
Yeah, I noticed. Yeah.
pretty good. That's called the It's Been Lonely Since the Divorce body language. Okay, so then we got to the restaurant, dance place, and I thought, maybe we could pull this again into something, fun. And then, of course... The girls went straight to the bathroom and the argument continued, but we listened on the headphones. Let's have a look at this.
The girls are in the bathroom right now, but we can hear them on their cordless mics. They're arguing about PETA.
That's your opinion.
Difference of opinions. That's all it was.
You went on and on and on.
So did you.
Yeah, I was being serious. I wasn't being sarcastic.
I was serious, too.
I was trying to listen to what you said. But
I was serious, too.
I was sitting over here trying to talk to you. Over here.
It had nothing to do with you.
You're being sarcastic, and I wasn't. So we were on different levels.
We were.
If I was being sarcastic,
we were.
And you did not stop because you have no sense of situation.
We were.
That is my opinion.
I wasn't ridiculing you. I was really cuting the position of PETA.
But then after that, I can't even... Just get... See, that's why I turned off my microphone, so I won't have those people in my ass.
Yeah.
Thank you, Roger Ladd. That was our evening. No, but I think the two girls separately may have been, quite charming individually. They just didn't get along together. That's all.
Some other time.
So that was the evening. Everyone, they couldn't hang out with each other anymore, and we all went home.
That's
right?
Pretty much it.
Yeah. No, we all went home. That's what happened. Let me change the topic now. Quiznos. We had our powwow on the weekend. We went to Quiznos. We met some people out in Woodland Hills. And there we go, the Tuscan chicken salad on focaccia bread. Look at that. We're eating our delicious Parmesan and Asiago cheese on focaccia bread. There we are. Look at that little fella. Isn't he charming? Look at those nice people. Okay, that's enough. That's enough of that. That's enough of that. Quiznos. Toasty. Okay? Well, we had a good time. It was fun. It's nice to see everyone out there at a little powwow. Yeah, because we have a powwow sometimes on Saturdays. That is a really good sub. You know, how are you doing, Glenn?
Mouthful.
How are you doing?
Rude.
You having a good day?
Pretty good.
I don't feel like my suit fits tonight.
I think you've lost weight.
Yeah, I think I've lost about 20 pounds since the show started.
Because you're nervous and stuff?
It looked like...
I noticed it today. It looked a little bad. Yeah. What's your face? Looks
my face looks more gaunt. Yeah, somebody said I look like the Scarecrow from The Wizard of Oz. Anyways, we're the show's doing pretty good. You know, we're actually doing pretty good in the ratings. And we just wanted to... I wanted to take a second to thank everybody watching. And thanks, guys. No, thank you. I appreciate it. You know, I want to thank all you guys. I want to thank everyone watching who's been watching the show. But you know, it is still a little nerve-wracking around here because every morning this thing comes in on a computer and we get a call from the network, mm-hmm. and they say the rating, okay? And if the rating is like a little higher that day, they're really happy.
Right.
Okay? But if it's a little lower that day, even though it's still, you know, they're reasonably happy.
Pissed off.
They're kind of pissed off. Yeah. And so we were just thinking that maybe we could just take a second, everyone watching, at the beginning of the show, because this is when the ratings are registered in the first half of the show, to pick up your telephone, maybe just call a friend or something like that, and just tell them to tune in tonight. That would really help Glenn and I out. So I'll wait here for a second while you do that. Just to kind of help Glenn and I out, you know. Go get someone out of the other room or something like that. Just tell them to come watch the show. Just hang on. Just because Glenn, you know, could really use the job, and I appreciate it as well, so. Just pick up the phone and call your neighbor. Run over to your next-door neighbor. Tell them to tune in. It's not a lot to ask. Think that's enough time?
Okay.
All right, thanks, guys. Thank you, and seriously, for those of you out there that called, thank you. You're really helping us out. That's pathetic. Okay. We'll be right back with Steve-O from Jackass. Stick around. We're back. You know, we're always looking for new talent on the show. That's why recently we went out to an old folks home, actually, looking to get some potential interns for the show. We were thinking it would be fun maybe if we could get some people from the local old folks home, the senior citizens home, the nursing home, nursing home.
Say that.
I did say that one. to come down and maybe work our cameras and things like this. Well, we got there and we realized that there's also a large untapped resource of on-camera talent down there. Let's have a look at some of the people we met. Here's a clip of Maria Nelson that we met down there. Let's have a look here. We're outside a senior citizens activity center here in Burbank, California, just a few minutes away from our studio.
We're interviewing some senior citizens today, auditioning them for parts on our show, either technical or in front of the camera.
You have any experience on camera, singing, no. Dancing?
No.
So technical then?
Technical, whatever.
What do you say, maybe being a studio camera person?
All right.
Or an announcer, maybe?
Okay.
Or co-host?
Maybe.
So maybe you could come in and learn some new things with technology on the show.
Yeah, I'm gay. I'm black.
And you could make some space, outer space sounds and things, like a rocket ship
sure.
sound.
Sure.
Yeah. Could you do that
whatever,
now for us?
Whatever it is required.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Do that. Oh, yeah. That's great. That's exactly what we're looking for.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh. Tell me why you would like to work in television.
Well, I was on the stage from the time I was 5 till I was about 15 in England, in English pantomime.
Okay.
And I was Lulu Bell the Cow.
Lulu Bell the Cow?
Lulu Bell the Cow.
Were you wearing a cow costume?
Of course.
That's great. Okay, so...
I had two songs.
What are the songs?
It was called Soggy Bottom Mud to the tune of Mississippi Mud.
Soggy...
Bottom Mud.
Bottom... Mud.
My agent, when he saw me perform this, he put me in for the Gong Show.
May not have been good enough for the Gong Show, but you're good enough for us.
Thank you. Huh?
To have found a great new piece of talent out there, and I'd like to introduce Space Lady Maria Nelson. So much for doing that. You did a charming job.
I loved it.
Now, how long have you been performing for?
Oh, this is my first time on television.
First time on television, but... but I understand you have done some work in the theater.
Oh, yes. I have done some plays in Spanish in Peru and in Los Angeles.
Right.
Yes.
We actually came down to the nursing home to meet people to see if they'd want to run cameras
Excuse me, it's not a nursing home.
Oh, it's not?
No, it's a Jocelyn Adult Center.
Oh, the Adult Center.
And seniors go there in the daytime, and they socialize, and they play pool, they play cards, whatever, and they have fun. And they can always have lunch if they buy their lunch there, too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I'm a volunteer there in the nutrition office.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sorry. Sorry about that. Well, as I was saying, we were down at the nursing home.
I'm not ready yet for the nursing home.
No, you're not ready for the nursing home yet. You sure about that? Okay. Well, we'll be right back with Steve-O right after this. You did a great job. Charming. He's best known for his outrageous antics on the show Jackass. We all know him, Steve-O. Let's take a look at this clip.
I'm Steve-O, and this is Bobbing for Jellyfish. And this is the jellyfish yarmulke.
Put your hands together for Steve-O.
Yeah, he was talking smack about
it. He told us about the drugs in the the drugs in the body. Yeah. What exactly happened there in Sweden?
It was a little skit I was filming for my own Steve-O video, Volume 3. And the skit's called Poo Rubber. So I took a condom and loaded it up with some marijuana and some hash. Tied it in a knot. I swallowed it. So I wanted to be able to dig through my poo.
Right.
And roll a joint,
sure.
You know? And say, that's good.
Right, right, right. But no, I mean, it was kind of a big ordeal. It got stuck in your throat.
Yeah, I got
and then you ended up in jail in Sweden, right?
Yeah, it was really a nightmare. Like, the first time, I mean, I was just kind of giggling, like, isn't this funny? Like, this huge package of marijuana, and I just couldn't swallow it. The third try, I got it stuck in my throat.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I panicked me, like, I couldn't get it to go up or down. I was trying to vomit it out, and I was just vomiting blood.
Right. And then, they came through you in jail.
Finally it got down. But it was days went by, and then nothing was coming out. I was really digging through my poo.
Right, sure.
Looking for it. And I mean, nothing was coming out. And to promote my tour, I had, all these interviews come through the hotel, and every one it said, well, I swallowed this marijuana, and it's not coming out. You know, like, I mean, it's in me. You know, I think I might die of intestinal strangulation.
Right, yeah. You gotta be careful.
So the police read the newspaper, and... luckily, I did crap out the poo rubber after 6 days.
Yeah.
I crapped out the poo rubber. It was great shit.
Right, sure.
I swallowed it. Yep. God, I'm a bloody mess. Hmm.
Okay, what's this all about?
All right, this is just...
you asked to have a knife here, so...
Yeah, you know, like, I'm really excited to be here because for some reason, your show is cutting edge enough that I'm allowed to do stunts I was never allowed to do on Jackass.
Okay.
Yeah, and I want to thank you for that, Tom.
Okay.
So what I have here is this ridiculous butcher knife.
Okay.
And to prove that I'm talented, see, my family, like my father tells me he's not proud of what I'm doing because I'm not showing talent.
Sure, well.
So now I'm going to show you that I am talented.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to balance this butcher knife on my nose.
All right.
I'm gonna let go of it. I'm gonna balance it perfectly. Oh.
Wow, your nose is bleeding right now.
Is it?
Your nose is bleeding.
Yeah.
You're like, now what, you were in the circus?
Actually, I was, yeah. I graduated from Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Clown College.
That's one of somebody you really look up to is P.T. Barnum, is that right?
Absolutely, yeah. And Houdini.
Your nose is bleeding.
Right.
So, what's some of the stuff you did in the circus? You were, like, doing stuff on cruises, and then you got fired or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I was like, I was a clown, but I wasn't really trying to be funny. I was more just trying to do stunts.
Uh-huh.
You know, when I was in the circus, I used to light myself on fire.
Sure.
Yeah. I really did. Yeah.
Really? Okay. Now you have some fire here. You're gonna do today.
I do.
Right? Okay.
I do.
I'm sorry. It's a little distracting because your nose has blood on it. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I just put a freaking butcher knife on my nose.
Yeah.
You're
not worried about it going in your eye.
No, I really am worried about going
to my
eye.
Have you ever
Every
hurt yourself?
Every time I do that.
What are some of the injuries you've had?
One time I was jumping off this second floor balcony, I landed on my face, I broke my cheekbone, like 7 teeth, 10 stitches in my chin, and a broken wrist.
Jeez. Okay, well, we have a clip of some stuff, some other stuff, some butt piercing, some worm snorting. Let's have a look at some of this stuff right here.
Cheeks pierced together, you know?
Chris Davis, take a really deep breath in. Hold it. And let it out. There, huh?
You look really cool, Steve.
Yeah, dude, I just got my butt pierced.
Someone told me, someone you did told me you did the butt piercing thing to, like, impress...
I was trying to hump the butt piercer.
Right, right.
She wasn't a butt piercer before. She's a body piercer.
Right.
Now she wanted to hump her, yeah.
Now she's sort of... she has butt piercing to add to her resume now.
Yep.
Yeah. And did it work?
Yeah, I pierced her.
Yeah. Boy, I heard you got in some trouble yesterday in Ohio. Is that true?
Did I get in trouble yesterday?
I don't know. That's what someone told me. You were on the phone talking to one of our producers, and they said the cops,
oh,
the cops
yeah,
came.
Yeah, when I was accused of giving marijuana and alcohol to, like, underage girl.
Sure. Okay.
I don't remember doing it. It didn't happen.
Yeah. But you're not, I mean, you're all, I mean you got thrown in jail in Louisiana.
Yeah, for stapling my nuts to my leg. Yeah.
Okay. Now, what I don't understand is because you do this, you do a traveling show, right? And And you staple your scrotum to your leg every night.
When I'm in Europe especially, like, they're really liberal about male nudity in Europe. Europe's really hard on my ball bag.
I guess, yeah.
You know? And, like, in America, like, in the States, if shows are, like, 18 and up, like, the show I got arrested for, it was an 18 and up show. Okay. So, I mean, it's all adults paying money to see me staple my nuts, you know?
Right,
and,
sure.
The state of Louisiana had me arrested on a fugitive warrant and, like, extradited or whatever.
Okay.
So, the bail was set for pulling out my wiener and stapling my nuts. Bail was set at $1 million.
Wow.
$1 million wiener.
All right. So we have some fire over here.
Yeah, now that this is, like, I mean, you know what it's like. Like, we've both worked for MTV, you know, before.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're pretty good at it.
It's fun, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a fun place to work.
Yeah, and from the very beginning, like, I was always wanting to share my unconventional ways of playing with fire.
Okay. Well, let's see what you want to do.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's really kind of mellow. It's just something I want to, like, it's an itch I want to scratch.
Okay.
I've always wanted to light myself on fire on MTV.
All right, well, don't...
And only now on your show am I allowed to.
Okay.
So somebody make some noise for Tom.
Okay.
Yeah.
Please do not try this at home. Do not try this at home, please. Okay, do not try this at home. Steve-O. Okay.
Can I get the lights down a little bit?
We bring the lights down a little.
Yeah.
Dramatic lighting. You were just showing me your ass.
I was.
You have, you did. And your tattoo. You want to show the people your tattoo and your ass? Yeah, there we go.
My ass. I'm a rock star now. I've been touring with Lollapalooza.
Yeah.
I'm stapling my ass every day.
There we go. Stapling your ass right there. You zoom in there, you can see there's... You can see here there's staple marks right there. You zoom in. Right there. Staple marks. All right. Ed Scott. Okay. All right. Well, that's very charming. All right, let's have a hand for Steve-O. Now we're going to begin a new bit, a regular bit on the show. Funny French people. Be right back with Bubba Sparks.
Welcome to the Café Roussel Altam. It was built in 1844 to 1857.
Okay, we're in the lighthouse right now. We're in the lighthouse. We're in the lighthouse. We're in the lighthouse. We're in the lighthouse. We're inside the lighthouse.
Inside the lighthouse?
Yeah, we are inside the lighthouse.
You go up just to follow.
It's okay. I smoke. So, it's the escalier, the stairs, it's très boutard.
Okay.
No, I don't smoke. J'ai fumé le cocaine, the crack.
Oh, For to hold the guitar. And the gargoyle.
Oh, yeah. Can I go inside?
Yes.
Maria, how are you doing? Maria?
I'm doing great.
What's that? Lift up. Say hi to Steve. Steve-O, Maria,
hi,
Nelson.
Hi, Steve. How are you?
Steve-O.
Huh?
Steve-O.
Oh, Steve-O. Oh, okay, Steve-O. You're doing okay.
I'm a bloody mess, but I feel great, and I'm totally
All right. Glad everyone's getting along here. Our next guest, Bubba Sparks, is a rap artist from the backwoods of Georgia. He has a new CD entitled Deliverance, which is going to be in stores September 16th. Check out this clip.
This musical marriage is no coincidence. So my mama sent me, baby, we shall have deliverance. So he say,
I've been traveling for some time. When my vision falls and my father shines.
How you doing, man?
Tommy G, what's happening with you, babe?
Not much. We were just down in Georgia.
What y'all doing down there?
Glenn and I were hitchhiking through Georgia.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Y'all had y'all little run through the south or whatever.
Yeah,
then.
That's cool.
Yeah, I bet it was.
You grew up on a dirt road in Georgia.
Absolutely.
You got moonshine here, is what this is?
Yeah, man. I do got some moonshine right here. You think you might want to indulge yourself in some with me? I brought some,
All right.
I got some good. You in?
So this is a...
I knew Steve-O was going to be in.
Yeah.
I even got one for the space lady, right? I got to involve the space lady.
So this is,
Glenn, I know you tore up all the time anyway, man. It's just...
We're not taking the funk here. This is grain alcohol.
Man, absolutely, baby. That's the truth, baby. You can't half step where I'm from, baby.
You make this stuff yourself, or?
Actually, this was made by some real good friends of mine, some old boys I know from Greenville, South Carolina.
Uh-huh.
My boy Fisher down in Greenville, my boy Murph Dahl down in Greenville. They made this. Yeah, pour them on up, man.
Yeah, okay, here we go. Yeah.
Be careful, man. This is the truth.
This is the truth.
This might well have been the stuff you was over there making the flame with.
So now, how long you been rapping for?
I've been rapping for about 12 years, man.
Don't waste it, Maria says. Every
come on,
drop
Glenn.
Counts.
Get with it, Glenn. Come on, space lady. Hey, this is true, now, space lady. This is true, baby. Yeah. Hey, we're going to toast it like this. Hold up. We got to make the toast to all that was, all that is, and all that shall be the new South, baby. Let's do it. Here we go. That backwoods potion, baby.
You all right, man?
Oh, my God!
That's the truth, man.
Yeah, that's my homeboy right there.
Okay,
come on, sir. You sure?
You
good? You good?
Yeah, I'll do it. I keep doing them.
Yeah, no, I don't know if you
get wasted.
Yeah, man.
So, okay. Let's talk about something.
What we need to talk about?
Huh? I don't know. So you grew up in rural Georgia.
Man, I grew up on a dirt road about 20 minutes north of LaGrange, Georgia, which is about an hour southwest of Atlanta, Georgia.
And
basically, man, like, you know, I do the rap thing, man. What I do is no different than what what, you know, cats have been doing for urban areas for the past 20 years since hip-hop was born.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm basically just painting a picture of rural life, because the same thing is going on everywhere.
people
burning in the throat! Woo!
So people in Georgia listen to a lot of rap music? I would have thought they'd listen to more country
man.
Music.
Well, I mean, you know what I'm saying? Out there in the rural areas, man, people pretty much listen to everything. That a boy. And but you know, Atlanta's been a major part of the hip hop scene for a while, since like the early '90s when Outkast first came out.
Yeah,
that's pretty much like, you know, like that's the pioneers of Georgia hip hop. Outkast.
Cool. Well, you know, I make beats.
I heard you.
Yeah,
did,
I make
man.
Beats.
What you got over here?
I've got my drum machine here.
Man, you better not be half stepping over here.
I was under the.
What you got, man? Let's cut off
here.
What
I was under
got?
The impression that maybe you might want to do some rapping.
What you got?
Let's see if I can do a better.
Come on, man. I thought you was qualified.
Okay, so you're gonna do a little freestyle?
Let's see,
this?
Man. Let's hear your beat. Y'all feeling that one? That's a groove. All right, Timberland did it. Yeah. A lot of y'all was thinking that Bubba would probably disappear. Give some show money from Mugly and buy a keg of beer. And another pig to give my other pig some company. Rent a double wide and just live it out in luxury. In due time, but his business left to 10-2. I need another farm to bequeath my next of kin to. And another tractor for my great aunt Missy. Yeah, I've been drinking, but I ain't that pissy. Woo!
So this is the CD Deliverance, and it's available now in stores, right?
Nah, it's going to be available September 16th.
September 16th. Okay,
but,
cool.
Let's jinx that, dude.
You may remember my next guest from last week. He's a nuclear physicist. He's a self-proclaimed UFOologist, and we ran out of time with him last week. Let's bring out Dr. Franklin Rule. All right, we don't have a lot of time.
Space lady.
All right, we don't have a lot of time. We've run out of time again, so we got to do this quick.
Last time, I only got 3 minutes, 11 seconds, Tom. I was supposed to get 7.
I think you had about 4.5
No,
minutes.
I timed it. It was 3 minutes, 11 seconds, and I wouldn't lie about that.
Well, I think it was more like around 4:30. So you're a UFOologist.
Ufologist.
Okay, ufologist.
Yes, I present the scientific evidence for UFOs and ETs. And I just wanted to continue what I was talking about last time.
So it's ufologist.
Ufologist.
Not UFOologist. Okay. And now you believe there's Martians living on the planet, Martianized underwater in the Bermuda Triangle.
I'm saying that we could have an ET base under the Bermuda Triangle. There are two purposes they might be doing. First of all, if they are from a colder planet and want to cool down our planet, they could do invoke what's called iron fertilization. They would distribute iron throughout the oceans that would increase planktonic growth, which would then draw down CO2 in time, cooling our planet. Now, you laugh at this, but actually one theory is that last ice age occurred when winds blew iron dust into the oceans and caused this very effect.
You believe in two-headed dinosaurs?
Yes. Would you like to see one?
Yes.
Okay. This is a two-headed T-Rex, yes. Now for those, we have today on Earth, yes. We have on Earth today, Tom, two-headed frogs, two-headed snakes, and even a two-headed fish from up in Washington.
This is a rubber toy.
I wouldn't call this a toy. This is a very authentic model, and I paid quite a bit for it, yes.
Okay.
$1.
All right, can I see? Let's
yes,
on.
You can.
You have now, a shoelace bazaar.
Yeah, but I want to explain why these might have existed.
Okay.
Just let me tell you, you know.
We got a minute left.
The dinos were oviparous or egg-laying entities, just as frogs and snakes.
Okay.
So a two-headed entity would have a better chance of surviving the passage through the birth canal.
Okay.
So I'm going to make a prediction right here on the new Tom Green Show that within the next 20 years, a paleontologist somewhere on Earth will find one dino fossil with two heads and have to concur that such entities did indeed exist.
All right.
And they may.
Let's see the shoelace bazaar. You have a shoelace bazaar.
Yes.
You gotta take another shot of that,
yeah,
baby.
I'm chasing that.
Let's take a shot to the two-headed dinosaur.
You want one?
No, I've got to keep my wits about me.
To the two-headed dinosaur.
To the two-headed dinosaur.
To the two-headed.
Okay, what's this? We have a minute left.
Shoelace bazaar. Okay. A bazaar is an item that a person swallows. In this case, this was a mental patient swallowed 290 shoelaces that got lodged in his GI tract that had to be surgically removed. Yes. Okay. Now, people.
But I don't even know what you're talking about right now.
A bazaar. A bazaar is B-E-Z-O-A-R. For any of you who happen to be taking notes, it's anything that you get lodged in your throat. Today, people
bazaar
are overdoing
bazaar. People Steve-O over- had a bazaar in Sweden.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it was a...
today, people, when you pay attention to...
A marijuana bazaar.
Look, people are taking, ingesting too much fiber.
Okay, we're out of time. We're out of time.
You can't do this.
We'll have you back on the
no,
show.
No, come on.
We'll
now,
have
I...
you back. No, we're out of time.
Do not overdo it on fiber. You can develop a fiber bazaar that would have
That's
to be surgically removed.
Yeah. I want to thank Bubba Sparks. I want to thank Steve-O. I want to thank Maria Nelson. I want to thank...